All right, we have got it to run and start. Now we have to fix the fuel tank. So, that's our next goal here. Windy out here, was it? Mm-hmm. I told your sister the other day, I'm not listening to you when you tell me it's warm or cold outside anymore. So every time you tell me it's fine, every time you tell me it's fine, I come outside and I'm like, no, it's not. We're gonna be out there for hours. You know what? That almost threads in. Check that out. Well, let's get crazy. Take one of these.
Okay.
Flat washer. Grab the drill and a drill bit, just any bit. So we can shave it. There you go. Give me the drill. Oh. Now I'll get that in a minute. It's gone. Now I'm not running through the mud to get it. I'll let it stick to a tractor over there. I'll go grab it.
Doesn't matter which one?
Any bit, just so we can rip it out. Oh, I thought you. Is the drill bit in there?
No, over here.
Oh. Is the drill bit? Are the drill bits? Got you on camera. Yeah. Yeah. Did you get your knee on it?
Yeah.
That was funny. It went up there by the dozer. Somewhere. Did you find it? Did you find it? Up a little bit. Got to slide on. That's right. Perfect. We're gonna take one of us some pair of washers. Like that. And you said you could get your hand in there? Alright.
Jesus.
Nah, yeah, that and this.
We're not using that old.
Okay.
The old grommet.
Nah, I think this will work even better.
I need another one of these.
See the on the inside. Rubber washer down, plastic. Okay. Go ahead. You said you'd get your hand in there, right? Okay. I'll hold the valve.
All right.
So. It doesn't have to be like torque tight, just good and tight. You take your watch off? Your sleeve up, may not. I hope we get your hand out. If not, it's on camera. You feel it? Can you? No?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm about to get Christy. Alright, just take your hand out.
I just don't know if that's a. I got
it's
the
on.
Washer on there. It's just, I think this needs to be walled out just
okay.
A little bit more. Like on the sides.
Okay.
The forearm is just almost too big.
Do I need to have Christy do it?
Nah, I think I can get it. We'll see. Let's try it again.
Yeah, we need plastic and fuel. Alright.
Okay.
You got it?
Here we go.
The green is still on there?
Yep.
Shit going, I've drilled it out quite a bit.
Well, it's only sticking up so far, too. Okay, I have a set in there.
Okay, can you get the thread on?
Hold on, hold on. Move in. I just have to keep the plastic on there. That's the problem.
Then let me take it out and drill it again.
Hold on. It's just barely sticking out. The problem is...
Let me see.
Here, let me just put the plastic on there so you can see.
Just take that rubber washer on the inside out, then.
It's not sticking out.
It's not a thread. Okay, take that rubber washer out. I've got one on the outside, so it shouldn't matter.
Yeah, that should work.
Shake the rubber out. Tight enough. She's getting tight.
Can you twist it?
I can't. Oh, I'm breaking it probably. Let me see. Lego. How tight it is. Lego. Let's put a little gas in it and see.
Okay.
I think it's going to leak.
Try and get that, plug that rubber. Hold on. Let's shake it.
You just turned it upside down. Get your hand out.
I'm trying to get that rubber.
Take your hand out. We'll just shake it out.
Here.
There
you
go.
Yeah.
All right, pull the gas in. Let's see if it leaks or not. I think it's going to leak.
Think so?
I think so. We'll see.
Let's we'll pour it back in. I guess what we could do is flip it. We could take the rubber one off the outside.
Let's just try.
Hey, what the well is flip it.
What do you think?
I think it's going
to try maybe seal between here.
Yeah, try maybe putting the rubber on the inside. think if we had the rubber on the inside, it would come out. This way, it's always going to be sitting.
We can try. Try it, I guess. Crusty did it? Twist? Yeah, you got it.
Can you twist a little bit?
Not really.
Well, that's pretty tight. Okay. I need to get that rubber piece out that I stuck in there, though. Awesome. I like that better.
Let's see. Put some gas in. Follow you. Find out.
Oh, it's coming out the hole. It's coming out the other stuff too.
Problem
is it just doesn't stick out far enough.
Still a bunch in there. Okay. Need a funnel. Grab that funnel right there in front of you. Chance.
There's one funnel right there.
Here. Hang on, I'll just open the bottom. It's all turning. Alright.
I guess we could try smushing it. Problem is,
stick your arm in there and take that out. Thank you.
thick. Looks like a quarter inch. Just by the time we get all everything on there, it's just... What if we didn't have any washers? What if we had...
You have to have the washers. Seal anyway. That'll leak right between that and that.
Well, I'm just saying. I didn't put them in order.
Yeah.
I'm just showing you how much I had to work with. Like I don't even have a quarter inch.
Well, here's where we're not. Here's where we're leaking. Plan B. Nah, so I can hold it. Gas leak right up. So, I'll back in there. Take that. Where's the original stuff? It's on the front porch, you got it? By the door. Chance it's outside on the front porch. It's on the front porch. I didn't pick it up. Oh, it's right here. I got it. My bad. Must have grabbed it. Wire brush out of the turbo box out there. And some brake clean.
The wire brush looks different.
New.
Looking for the wood. Plan B?
I don't have a plan B. I'm just cleaning this out.
Okay.
Thought that grommet were kind of hosed.
So that one worked. We probably could just...
Gas for sure. I don't know why you down to sell a rubber grommet like that.
kind of like a plug.
Well, it does two things. It seals that hole and seals around this. Going right around everything. There's even though this is sealed here, threads seal around the top, it's just leaking around the hole. Going right down the threads. Just running right down. No version of that's gonna work. It's gonna run down the threads every time. The only way that works is if we had a no rubber grommet like this one to seal those threads off.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't think about it running down the threads.
What if we had some sort of like hose that we could like shrink around this? Side. That makes sense. So
I don't have any hose like that.
It'd be nice if we had something like that would keep it in place. But something where, like, if you had a piece of hose that was like bigger on this end but just a little smaller, you could feed it through there.
I don't know if there's any such hose. Most hoses are all made one diameter. You can't really shrink it on one end and make it on the other.
I was thinking like the heat shrink stuff, but
oh, I don't have any. No, I don't have anything like that. I ain't have any rubber hose that big.
The way around this.
Well, the way around it is to buy the right part.
Definitely want this right here. You just popped it on.
Yep.
Man, how'd you get down there? Just wiggle it.
Yep. There's no way that's gonna work. There's nothing to keep it in the hole. So this first bump you hit and the hose hangs on it, pops right out. That's what this top nipple's for. It's swollen to keep that seal, to keep it inside the hole.
Okay. That's why it looks like that. So it's just a grommet.
All right, so we could not get the factory bad boy rubber grommet for the fuel tank. It goes here. So we took a piece through his hose, cut it down, squished it in, shaved the inside out with a drill bit to make it thin enough where it now makes a seal. So now we have a seal again. Now we're gonna put it back in. Ready for installation, sir. You'll put that on last. Yeah, we're gonna pull that out of that so we have more slack. Go ahead and slide it out of that. Push it down through that. It's good. Yeah. We need more slack, so go ahead and push it through that. So we can, yeah, we'll go over the top of it. We can zip tie it another way. Yeah, it gives more slack. All right. I'll hold this up while you install said gas tank.
Definitely that size.
I don't think it even matters. Nah, that's perfect. Just like that.
It needs to go like that because it's going to go that way.
Okay, perfect. We do have it running on ether. Just a few seconds to make sure that it would run and the tank had a bunch of water in it. So, we disconnected all the fuel stuff, cleaned it all. Now we're ready to go back together with it. I know why they quit making these bad boys. They're not well engineered.
It's gonna take a minute.
No worries. A sock and an impact. We had the floor plate. Now we're gonna take the floor plate out, but we didn't have to. It wouldn't start either. The brake switch is bad, which it has a park switch, which you have to have the brake on to find what I would call safety neutral. So we had to bypass that just to see if we could get it to start, and it does work. You don't have to be super tight. It's got heavy fuel in it. You're good. That's perfect. Yeah, perfect. Yeah, it's not that much bouncing action up here. Dude, that'd have done an impact on a socket. Is that 5/16ths? 3/8ths. Alright. He wants to do it old school. We'll hook the lights back up. Oh, sorry. My fault. Got all the water out of the tank, if you can see that. It took us about an hour. Went to Lowe's, bought a bunch of fittings. None of it even worked. And we had what we needed here on the farm just laying around as usual. Just stuff we keep, like most farms do. That's probably a good chance.
Yeah?
Yeah. But ain't going anywhere. All right, hook the lights back all up. If you would, sir. Right here. That's good. I hooked the fan up already. We'll re-zip tie that. We didn't put it back in their zip tie loom, but that's fine. We'll re-zip tie it. Okay, everything looks good there. All right, now when you put the fuel line back on it.
You going to pour some gas?
Sure. It's up to you. All right, let me hold the trunk up for you, or the hood. The hood, the bonnet, as it were.
Bonnet?
Yeah, that's what they say in Europe.
The bonnet,
yeah. Let's put about a half tank in it so we can get it running. It's like it holds probably 2-3 gallons maybe.
Go.
Now the river's flowing. You check and make sure it's not leaking. Nope, no drip whatsoever. probably good. See if we can get it running. See, is it submerged? Oh yeah. And that's actually fuel line that I had laying there too.
Yep.
Fuel cap.
All right.
That tried hood is terrible. All right. Let all that horsepower rest. A little hood. All right, you gotta hook the fuel line back up. Turn the wheel again. You hear this tire back up, it went flat. You still gotta dismount this tire. Clean the bead out. If we decide to keep it, it's gonna need more new tires anyway. This is sitting for about 3 years. Once we got it picked up.
Hey, do you want to blow this out first? You said you blow the fuel line out.
I cleaned it.
You already cleaned it?
It's done. I hooked it up on the other side. Carburetor side. Take the hose off, blew it out. Back flushed, as they call it. It was bone dry anyway.
Was it?
Yeah. It hadn't had fuel in it in a minute. We do have the valve off, by the way, so when you get that hook back up.
Open it.
Yeah, just remember to open it. You put the C-clamp back on it. Can't, hang on, we got that clamp to put back on that hose. Where's the original hose?
The C-clamp's underneath. There
it is right there. Here, if you'll use this, this is the right size. You have to use a stupid screwdriver.
No, a little smaller.
Okay, quarter inch. Get you the right size. It's a lot easier to use. Here you go. Open it, loosen it. You gotta get the clamp on first, right?
Yeah,
I got
it.
Okay.
I'm trying to get this on the nipple.
Make sure the clip's far enough back. If not, it'll stretch. Get it?
Not yet.
Make it leak. Hard to see back there.
Come on.
I'll hold it for you. Did you get it?
I'm gonna take a look at it. It's like close, but
let's see. At least the sun finally came out. Nah, clamp that.
Clamp it?
Yeah, clip right there on the end. I'm trying to look in there.
It's going on anymore.